What's up, guys? Hope you're doing great. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, please remember to subscribe because here we do photography and filmmaking based content. And if you're interested in that, of course, do that and turn on the post notification button so that you'll be always notified and you'll be the first to watch my videos anytime I upload them over here on my YouTube channel. All right, so let's get right into today's video. I'm going to talk about a photo shoot that I did outdoor and I actually used just sunlight. I was thrilled because the images that I was getting, all right, under normal circumstances, you're going to need a reflector or something to bounce light back because I was going to be using primarily backlighting for the photographs. Normally, I would shoot women, but this time I went with guys and they dressed appropriately for the occasion. The location is not something unusual. Normally, I would shoot somewhere there's just greenery, but here there's something much more interesting. There's a water body ahead of us, as well as the cottage or the building in which that we stood to shoot the pictures is actually made of wood, and so it had a lot of, you know, dark tones and brown tones that was gonna really work out with the skin tones of my models. And additionally, I have a go-to color grading style that looks very cinematic in its look, and yeah, that's exactly what I also went ahead when I was editing these images. But today we are gonna look at how I took the images and what I took into consideration, the environment, how best I harnessed its beauty and its aesthetics to come out with these images that you see right now. The schedule of the shoot was close to 5 p.m. I think that was around 4:30 or 4 o'clock. And you know that during that time, the sun is setting and the tones are always golden in look. And that was just perfect for the occasion. And so I harnessed the look of it to, you know, use it as a backlight. The sun, actually, that's what I'm talking about. The only light show that I actually used, I used it as a backlight, and that was just about that. But if I was using it as a backlight, normally you would have to bounce the light back. And here, talking about the cottage with its brown tones, there's no way that you're going to be able to have the light bounce back from the dark tones into the faces of the model to light them up and still have the sun back there, having the light up their back and create some halo effect over there. So it was quite of a challenge because I didn't come with my reflector. That wasn't the intention at all. But luckily for me, in this building or in the windows of this building are glasses, all right? And in fact, they have a very large space where the glass covers almost, let's say, 80% of that particular side where it faces the sun directly, and the sun sets perfectly in a spot where it bounces the light back from the reflectors, or here in this case, the glass, into the faces of the model. So yeah, I used it, but I had to be very careful not to catch my shadows in the shot. The only circumstance that I can remember was that because there's actually a public space and I mean, it's not controlled, you can't just go there and take pictures. Other people also use it, they pay to use the space. So I had a couple of other people, some photographers taking pictures of some newlyweds, and yeah, I had to, you know, still go ahead and take pictures, but we just had to be careful not to get into each other's way. So we were kind of communicating all along, and I think that's basically the only challenge that I faced. But for the most part, I took pictures of the first model who had this very, very, you know, unconventional look of a style of what he wore. He had this cloth covering himself up. The first one was actually blue and the second was red in tone. So I picked two spots for him, and the other model also came with something reasonably white, as well as the second look was he had these jeans top and the trousers was also in jeans, and yeah, so blue against the brown with a skin tone. They actually having similar complexions and skin, so I didn't have so much trouble matching the color grades in Lightroom when I was editing. So coming back to talk about the shoot, I used my Canon EOS 6D with my 18-35 1.8 Sigma Art Series lens, which I think basically I used that throughout the shoot. And because of its wide focal length nature, I could play along with, you know, some stretches and some contortions in the shots. And with that also applied, the sun also bounced back the light from the reflectors here again, the glass, back into their faces. And yeah, everything just resonated perfectly well. Almost everywhere on this building was actually, you know, made of wood. But the glasses were lined up perfectly well, that no matter where you stood, there was going to be a significant amount of light bounce back where the sun was shining against. So the models took turns in exactly where I shot the first model. The second also came through, and I shot in the same style, and sometimes, you know, anything that would, you know, motivate me or influence me to do something else, I just do that. And I tried a whole lot of setups, you know, in terms of positioning, as well as in terms of the camera settings and how much the light was being bounced off the reflectors, the mirrors or the glass. And I shot some of the shots having the model standing right in front of the glass. And also, I think one other challenge that I also faced was that there were reflections, of course, standing in front of glass or a mirror. You're definitely going to have things that are standing in front of it show. So I had to find a way to hide myself, as well as the people who were also present on that same location. I also had to be very careful about not having them get into the shot. Okay, so I think basically that was the challenge. And because of my understanding of light and how, you know, light actually works off of surfaces, I could harness that skill and that ability to come up with interesting configurations as well as angles. I shot some from the top, some from below. Some of them I use the live view, because with the Canon EOS 6D, you know, that it doesn't swivel with the screen, so I couldn't articulate the screen, and so I had to take it off my eyes, lay it down on the floor, take some shots and hope that it will come out right. But for the most part, most of the pictures came out right. And because of the contortions that the wide angle focal lens in the lens gave me, I could, you know, do a lot more than just take the portraits and not think about the background. And because I shot with mostly wide focal lens, I couldn't really have my background blurry. But I mean, it was part of it. The background was also part of the photographs. I wasn't just focusing on just my subject and isolating just my subject out of the background. But this time, everything had to come together as a whole, as a complete, you know, form or a complete composition to end up with a very good shot. All I needed to take care of was my composition, my framing, and also ensure that my subject was in focus. So basically, that's how I harnessed the sun, using the sun as my only light source to make the images appear as if I used two light sources, or even a traditional reflector that you may take along with you anytime you're shooting with natural light and you are going to practice it with backlighting. All right, so that actually ended the shoot, and I was very happy when I returned home editing the images. They were so easy to edit because of the colors and the compositions that I took. Also, the angles were so interesting, and yeah, you know, everything worked out perfectly well. So thank you very much for watching this video to the very end. If you are inspired and you are motivated to go take pictures during sunset with just the sun with no reflector, just challenge yourself. And I'm pretty sure that you can also walk home with wonderful images looking at what I was able to achieve. But first of all, you should always know that you need to understand how light works and how light affects subjects and objects. The environment is actually your studio. I've made a video about that. That was actually the last video before this one. And if you want to understand why I believe that the environment or the world is your studio as a photographer or a filmmaker, please check it out and you understand a whole lot more than just what I've said. All right. Okay. So yeah, once again, turn on the post notification button so that you'll be notified of future videos. Yeah. And until the next video, as I always say, have a wonderful day.